Hello friends, in this video I want to remind you something that I know most people have forgotten. Hello friends, in this video I'm going to remind you, or rather we are going to remind each other about something that is so long forgotten, yet it is clearly stated in the Bible, and that is about the fourth commandment. The Bible says in Exodus chapter 20 verse 8 to 11, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. In it you shall not do any work, you or your son or your daughter or your manservant or your maidservant or your cattle or the sojourner who is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, and the sea, and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. So again, reference is made to Genesis chapter 3, where God created everything that he made. Genesis, from Genesis chapter 1 to chapter 3, and we know in chapter 2 that the Lord blessed the Sabbath day in Genesis chapter 2 and hallowed it, for in it he rested. Now when we go to Isaiah, since we want to find out about a doctrine in the Bible, we will let the Bible be its own expository. So the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 28 verse 9 to 10, whom shall he teach doctrine, and whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breasts. For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little and there a little. So we're going to pick a few verses from the Bible, and we're going to let the Bible be its own expository. We'll begin our study with the book of Luke chapter 23 verse 54. We all know about the background information here. Jesus has been crucified, and they are about to put him to his grave, and we read from the Bible in the book of Luke chapter 23 verse 54. I'll be referencing two Bible translations, that is the Revised Standard Version, as you can see, and the Good News Translation. So the Revised Standard Version says that it was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning. Now, the same verse in Good News says that it was Friday, and the Sabbath was about to begin. That is, equating the day of preparation to Friday. That means the day of the preparation for the Sabbath is Friday. In other words, the day that precedes the Sabbath is Friday. Now we go to our next verse, which is the book of Matthew chapter 28 verse 1, again referencing the two Bible translations. It says in the Revised Standard Version that now after the Sabbath, toward the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the sepulchre. Now, when we read the same verse in Good News Translation, it says, after the Sabbath, as Sunday morning was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. You know, these women wanted to anoint the body of Jesus, but they found that he had already resurrected. We know that Jesus resurrected very early on Sunday morning, which the Bible tells us is the first day of the week. It was after the Sabbath. The first day of the week after the Sabbath. Now, which is the first day of the week, Sunday. The Bible has stated it very clearly that Sunday is the first day of the week. And the seventh day of the week, therefore, is Saturday. Because Friday, we are told, is the day of preparation for the Sabbath. And Sunday is the day after the Sabbath. So that means that Saturday is the seventh day of the week, which is the Sabbath. And Sunday is the first day of the week. And that is the day that we should rest. On Sunday, we should just work like any other day because it's the first day of the week. So that is it, guys. I hope you've learned something. And I hope you will align your lives to harmonize with what God and what the Bible teaches. May God bless you. And till next time, may God be with you.